Hello everyone, my name is Paschalis Karageorgis and I'm the course director in the School of Mathematics. In this presentation, I would like to give you an overview of the undergraduate programs that we offer at Trinity, both for single honor students who are studying mathematics alone and for joint honor students who are combining mathematics with another subject. First of all, why should you study mathematics? If you like working with numbers, if you like solving equations, if you enjoy combining various ideas in order to tackle a particular problem or puzzle, then mathematics would be a natural choice for you. The courses at Trinity are specifically designed to help you improve your quantitative skills and develop your reasoning ability. There will be lectures that you will need to attend, and those will introduce the underlying theory and the main concepts. There will also be some problem-solving sessions that you will need to attend, and those are called tutorials. Tutorials will give you the opportunity to discuss about the various concepts with your classmates and to work together on specific problems under the supervision of your instructor. They will help you to better understand and appreciate the overall concepts that will be introduced in the lectures. In addition, the curriculum is meant to combine all aspects of mathematics. There will be some emphasis on the theoretical aspects, including proofs, theorems and formal arguments. There will be some emphasis on the applied aspects that will allow you to understand where the equations are coming from, what are the applications in physics, biology, chemistry and other subjects. And then there will be some emphasis on the numerical aspects, which are equally important as well. In some cases, a computation could be extremely time-consuming to carry out by hand, so scientists get to rely on computer packages and mathematical software that help us perform the computation in a much more reliable and efficient manner. Also, the degrees are quite flexible and they provide a wide variety of optional modules. We feel this is very important because some students have a specific area in mind and they would like to concentrate on that area, so it's very important for them to be able to take as many modules within that area as possible. But there are also other students who do not have a specific pathway in mind. And in that case, they need to be able to explore all kinds of areas of mathematics. In addition, the fact that our degree is quite flexible allows our students to take advantage of the opportunities that Trinity gets to offer in terms of Erasmus and exchange with other universities. Since they don't have to take any compulsory modules during the third year, they can spend either half the year or even the whole year at one of our partner universities. We have a long list of universities in the UK, America, France, Germany, and other countries around the world that our students can visit and take modules there and have access to modules that are not necessarily offered at Trinity, have access to labs and facilities that are not necessarily available at Trinity. What are the future career options? As you can probably imagine from the variety of modules that we get to offer, our students get to pursue different kinds of directions as well. About one third to about one half of our students, depending on the year, get to continue on with postgraduate studies and research in various areas of mathematics. There are lots of master's programs and PhD programs at Trinity, other universities in Ireland, other universities in the UK, but virtually any country in the world that our students get to apply and get to visit in order to complete the studies, the postgraduate studies afterwards. In addition, they get to work in all kinds of areas. We have graduates who are currently doing research in theoretical mathematics, computer science, data analysis, statistics, and other areas like mathematical biology and neuroscience, for instance. There's also various opportunities in actuarial sciences, finance and banking. As you already know, there's a very well-established financial sector in the heart of Dublin and a very well-established financial sector in the heart of London that our graduate students have access to. And they have been extremely successful in obtaining positions in those areas due to their quantitative skills and due to the exposure to various opportunities like the summer internships that we get to offer every year, and the final year projects that they have to do during the final year. The final year projects are specifically designed to allow a student to familiarize themselves with an area of their choice and work under the supervision of their of a member of staff on a one-to-one basis, and build their familiarity with the subject and work in one particular area that they enjoy the most, whether it's mathematical finance or mathematical biology or any other application in mathematics. Finally, last but not least, there are lots of jobs in education, accounting, statistics or computer science that our students get to pursue, with some emphasis on statistics and computer science because there is a close connection between the School of Mathematics and the School of Computer Science and Statistics, and that allows our students to have access to a wide variety of modules in those areas. A few words about the course structure. Most of the degrees at Trinity have a duration of 4 years, and they are naturally divided into two parts. The first two years, are called the fresh years, and the last 2 years are called the sophister years. This is a natural distinction that applies for most of the degrees at Trinity, and the distinction makes even more sense in the case of mathematics because the approach, the goals, and the overall expectations are different during the first 2 years than they are during the last 2 years. So during the first 2 years, the fresh years, most of the modules will be compulsory. Our goal during those years is to make sure that everyone gets a solid background, that they will acquire knowledge that will be extremely useful for the later years and for the subsequent career paths. There are modules in linear algebra, calculus, programming, statistics, and other topics that I don't get to mention in this slide, like number theory and differential equations, for instance. We feel it's very important to have a background in all those areas because that allows students to appreciate and better understand the concepts when they look at them in all kinds of directions. In this slide, I've included a couple of plots. One of them, the one on the right, comes from the definition of an integral and computation of an area, which is an important application of calculus that students get to see from a theoretical point of view, and the computation of integrals, but also they get to see it through a numerical point of view, where the area is approximated using a computer program to calculate the sum of lots of areas of rectangles. Whereas on the left, I have a diagram that uses a computer package in order to plot some solutions of a standard model in mathematical biology, where X and Y refer to populations of a predator and a prey that somehow coexist and go into cycles, so that the populations sometimes increase, sometimes decrease, but they don't, neither of the populations becomes extinct. So these are kinds of problems, kinds of real life problems that the students get to see, and it's important to view them from different directions, sometimes from an applied, sometimes a more theoretical. Now, we don't expect our first or second year students to be exceptionally good in all areas. I guess that about 10% of our students will be exceptionally good in all areas, but most of them do well in some of them and get to develop the background to help them continue on with their studies. And then during the later years, the sophister years, they will focus, they will concentrate on some particular area. So the good thing and the nice distinction between the first 2 years of the degree and the last 2 years of the degree is that even though most modules are compulsory during the first 2 years and you're exposed in a variety of areas, the results that you will obtain during the first 2 years will not count towards your degree result. So the result that you will eventually get at the end of your studies will be based on your sophister years. On the modules that you get to take in your third and your fourth year. And the important part during those sophister years is that most of the modules will be optional. Those are the modules that you will get to choose depending on your interests and depending on your future plans. There is a wide variety of optional modules, and in areas such as applied and pure mathematics, geometry, Euclidean geometry, differential geometry, algebraic geometry, and so on, we have We are very fortunate to be able to offer a mathematics education module which allows students the ability to visit secondary schools, talk to teachers, talk to pupils, get more familiarity and more understanding in terms of how the secondary system, education system works. There is a module, there are several modules in mathematical economics and lots of modules in statistics and theoretical physics, which are starting out, in fact, from the first year, go on into second year, and students have a variety of options during their sophister years. So the only compulsory module during the sophister years, there's one and only one, and that's the final year project. And even that is in an area that the students get to choose, with a supervisor, a member of staff that they get to choose as well. Available pathways. I would also like to briefly discuss the options that the students have with looking at the looking at the diagram on the left that refers to the single honor students and the diagram on the right which refers to the joint honor students. I've only bothered to include the first 2 years of the degree just to give you an overall idea of what options are available. So during the first year, the junior first year of the degree, all single honor students take 60 credits in mathematics. So they will take some modules in algebra, calculus, and various aspects of applied mathematics, including statistics, programming, and mechanics, a very important area in theoretical physics. So that would be the first year, which roughly consists of 6 modules per semester. Now, at the end of the first year, they will have the ability of making a decision. They will be asked to decide between pursuing a single honors degree that will be concentrating on mathematics and mathematics alone, or they will have the ability of introducing a minor. So they can keep mathematics as their major subject, their major focus, but also have a little bit of emphasis on a second subject, and there are 11 possible choices: drama studies, English, French, geography, history, arts, Italian, music, religion, Spanish, and statistics. Pathways were introduced in 2020, and the most popular choice this year was statistics, which was also the most quantitative choice, needless to say. So the students who decide to pursue a single honors degree will still have some access to other subjects, so they will mainly concentrate on mathematics, but they will have the ability of taking general modules, like language modules, a module in French or German or Korean or other languages, or modules in areas of general interest, like history or art. So they will be concentrating mainly on mathematics, but they will have the ability of taking some modules in other areas. In the case of their second year, it will be 2/3 of their modules concentrating in mathematics, including computer science, statistics, and other aspects of mathematics, but a quantitative kind of approach. And 1/3 of the modules could be in other areas that are not as quantitative, like the ones that I mentioned, language modules and modules of general interest. The students who get to do a minor in another subject will take 2/3 of the modules in mathematics, and that will be their major, and 1/3 of the modules in another topic of their choice, like music, for instance. So someone, a student who wants to do a major in mathematics combined with a minor in music, will have to take 2/3 of the modules in mathematics and 1/3 of the modules in music, at least for the second year. The decision that students get to make at the end of the first year is not by any means a commitment. So it will determine their path during the second year and allow them to get exposure to a different subject like music during the second year. But if that is not what they expect, if they're not particularly happy with their minor, then they have an option of dropping the minor and going back to the single honors pathway a year later. So you will have the opportunity of taking some modules in Spanish, music, Irish, or any of the other subjects, but in order to actually get a minor by the end of your studies, you will have to take 1/3 of your modules in that subject during your second, third, and fourth year, with the opportunity of going back to the single honors degree and forgetting about the minor if it is not what you expect. The analogous pathways for joint donor students are listed in the diagram on the right, and I will briefly go over that as well. The joint donor students are allowed to combine mathematics with one of five subjects that are listed here: economics, modern Irish, music, philosophy, or Russian. So these are the five joint donors combinations that are available at Trinity. Students who are studying two of the subjects enter during the first year with an equal balance between the subjects. So half of the credits will be in one subject, let's say mathematics, and the other will be in another, let's say economics, which is also the most popular choice in the joint donors program. Students who are studying mathematics and economics will study both subjects equally during the first year, and at the end of the first year, they will have to make a decision that will lead them into a single honors pathway so that they get to concentrate in one of the subjects. Maybe they're not particularly happy with one of the two, and they can switch from being a joint honors student to being a single honors student and eventually end up with a degree in economics or a degree in mathematics, depending on the subject that they get to drop. They could also pursue a major with minor kind of approach, which is similar to the one that's available for single honor students. So they study mathematics and economics equally during the first year, and then they decide that they like one of the two a little bit better. So 2/3 of the modules will be in one subject, and 1/3 of the modules will be in the other, in a major and minor configuration, and they will eventually end up with a degree with a major in mathematics and a minor in economics. A third possibility that's available for joint honor students would be a perfect balance. So you can take 20 credits in one subject, 20 in the other, and leave the remaining 20 credits, at least during the second year, to investigate and explore other general modules, like language modules and history or art modules that are of interest potentially to some of the students. Finally, I wanted to give some web pages that you could consult for further information, to look up additional pieces of information that I haven't included in this presentation. So there is a general website that the School of Mathematics gets to maintain. We have our own website that is in addition to the main tcd.ie website. So the undergraduate version of the undergraduate page of that website refers to the modules that we get to offer. If you go to that web page, you'll see the various courses that we get to offer: mathematics, single honors mathematics, joint honors mathematics. There's also a relevant, a related course in theoretical physics that gets to combine mathematics and physics. That might be of interest to you. The web pages contain a list of modules with some module outlines. Most of our staff members get to maintain a web page themselves with information about their own modules, homework assignments, solutions, or lecture notes that they get to post every now and then. So there's lots and lots of information that you can find through that website. For the moderatorship in mathematics, the part of the degree that refers to single honors mathematics students, the part of the degree that refers to joint honors as well. And last but certainly not least, I would like to give you the link for the Mathematical Society, which is a student society that we get to maintain, that our students get to run within Trinity. A very active and very successful society, I have to say, with lots of events throughout the year. Unfortunately now with the COVID-19 situation, they're not as active as they want to be, but under normal circumstances, and hopefully starting next year, they will be going back to organizing seminars, student talks, get-togethers. They have a special room where they get to meet and interact with one another on a daily basis. So whenever they don't have lectures or tutorials, they come together, talk to one another, and socialize. It's a very, very pleasant atmosphere, and a very good opportunity for the students to talk and mingle with one another outside of the classroom. I do hope that you found my presentation useful. My email is listed on the first page, and please feel free to send me an email should you need any additional information about our courses. Good luck with your studies, and thank you very much for your attention. Thank you.